Tell me about the women in your world, Captain.
The only thing I was going to hope to do different was do more love stories once I heard about the woman problem situation. I received a visit from the head of network research. And he said to me, he was there to help me. They had done a lot of research. I said, okay, well, how do you help me boost the ratings?
Let me help. 100 years or so from now, I believe, a famous novelist will write a classic using that theme. He'll recommend those three words even over I love you.
And he said, well, the only way he could see to do it was to broaden our base of women viewers. We had some very loyal women viewers, but the great majority of women, according to his research, were terrified at the thought of space.
Captain, I'm...
Well, who are you? You're the only one who can do it. I'll be right there.
Yes, sir.
They needed parameters. In other words, in ordinary, regular, everyday TV, if you're going to do a story about a woman, don't do it on a mountaintop, do it in a valley.
That is good. Is there a woman for you?
No, there isn't.
The common thought was, of course, that he was had a very an unhappy marriage, divorce, with a daughter whose name was Joanne, who we never got to. We were going to do a series about her. Not a series, but an episode with her.
Oh, honesty is usually wise.
And, of course, the third year they sent us down the sewer. We didn't get to do that. Would have been interesting. They were talking about bringing her on board.
Mr. Spock, you seem to understand these people. You will deal with them.
We respectfully request that you take us to Eden.
I have orders to the contrary. This is not a passenger ship.
Herbert! 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 Herbert!
The hippie one. I can't even remember the name. That's why it's my least favorite.
I'm sure that had they brought her on board, that our captain would have had eyes for her in some way that could upset the hell out of McCoy, I tell you that.
It all seems rather indecent to me.
But he is a southerner out of the south, and I think just was such an unhappy guy that he joined the service, decided he would, you know, abandon what practice he had. And that's about all that was really ever known about him or thought about
it. You have lived a lonely life?
Yes. Very lonely.
On a personal level, I had been trained classically, and so I was into the Shakespeare hero. I had come off of, before Star Trek, I'd come off of the greatest human hero of all, I think. Alexander the Great had conquered the known world.
If I'm to be the woman of a Caesar, can't I know what you're up to?
He was young and apparently beautiful, and he rode his horses, and he had, you know, he had all the components of what we think of being heroic.
And before I put you in the brig, there's a little something I owe you.
And I had played him, and then my next big gig was Star Trek, so I think I brought some of Alexander the Great to Captain Kirk.
A canal, and with it we'll bring the water from the lake right to the lodge. And we can expand the system, see? And irrigate the fields and double the food supply.